Good evening. Our next topic for today is constructor overloading, or it is also called as multiple constructors in a class. So this question is also a very important point from exam point of view, which comes for 5 marks in short notes. So if it is asked for 5 marks, you have to explain what do you mean by constructor overloading and a small program using constructor overloading. So what do you mean by overloading? When the same function name is used to perform different tasks, then we can say that that function gets overloaded. Similarly, if the same constructor name is used to perform the different tasks, then we can say that the constructor gets overloaded. We have already seen the types of constructors, that is default constructor, parameterized constructor and copy constructor. We can have all the three constructors in the same program also. Consider this example where they have mentioned all the three types of constructor in the same class. Class integer, which has two variables m and m in the private area. In the public area, we have constructor defined here. The first constructor is called default constructor because it does not have parameters provided here. It means that it assigns the default values to integer parameters m and n to as 0, 0. That is m equal to 0 and n equal to 0 here. In second constructor, this is called as parameterized constructor, where it takes two parameters, integer a comma integer b. It means that what are the values that we are going to pass into a and b gets assigned to m and n by this function. So m is assigned a value and n is assigned b value. In the third constructor, if you see how it has been written, in the parameters, it is referring to the object of the same class. It means this is a copy constructor. The ampersand symbol written before the object, it is nothing but the reference to the object of the same class. The purpose of this constructor is to copy the object values of one object into another object. So this method is going to copy I dot m into variable m and I dot n into variable n, and at last we terminate the class like this. So how a call is made in the main program to these constructors? Suppose there is a call or a line like this into the main program, integer I1 semicolon. It means we have not specified here any parameters to this object. It means that this is going to call the default constructor. So this line not only creates object I1 but also initializes the values of m and n to 0. There is another line which creates I2 objects like this, integer I2 in bracket 20 comma 40. It tells the compiler that this is a parameterized constructor which takes two parameters 20 and 40, which gets later on assigned to the object m and n, object values m and n. M is assigned 20 and n is assigned 40 in this case. Third is integer I3 in bracket I2. It means that we have passed the object as a parameter to the constructor method. Whenever you pass the parameter object as a parameter to the constructor method, it is nothing but a copy constructor. Its job is to copy I2 object values into I3. Now we'll see a complete program using constructor overloading. Consider this example of a class complex which has two parts, real and imaginary part, x and y. X is real part and y is imaginary part. In the public area, we have three constructors. One is default, another is parameterized constructor here, and third is also a parameterized constructor. Then we have a method sum, function sum, which is declared friend to this class, and show function will display the value of the object. Now we'll see the definitions of each and every constructor method defined inside the class. First is default constructor. So there is no code written here. It means default values are assigned to x and y variable. that is 0.0 to x as well as 0.0 to y. In the second constructor, there are one parameter that we are given. It means both the real and imaginary part has assigned value a. Then there is third constructor, which is also a parameter constructor, which takes two different values, that is real and imaginary. Real part will goes into x variable and imaginary part goes into y variable. Now we'll see the definition of sum function. If you add two complex numbers, the return value must be a complex. That's why if you see here, this friend function takes two different objects of complex class. It performs addition of two complex numbers and at last it returns the complex number as an result. And show function is responsible for displaying that complex number, resultant complex value. Now we'll see the first definition of friend function sum outside the class. Friend functions are defined outside the class like a normal function. So if you see here, complex is the class name, sum is the function name. There are two parameters it takes, two objects c1 and c2 of complex type. We perform the addition of two complex number and we store the result into c3 object. So c3.x is nothing but the calculation of the real part of the third object. It is nothing but c1.x plus c2.x. So we are adding the real part of both the objects and storing the real part into the third object. Similarly, we add two imaginary parts c1.y and c2.y and we are storing it into c3.y. And at last this return statement will going to return the result to the caller. Now we'll see the definition of the sum function where it displays the complex number in the format of c.x j c.y. In the main program, whenever we go, we always create the object of the class first. So the first object A is created with two parameters 2.7, 3.7. It means in this case 2.7 is the real part and 3.5 is the imaginary part. Object B is created with this single parameter. It means here a second, it calls the second definition of the constructor where it took only one parameter. In this case, the real and imaginary part both are assigned 1.6 value. Then we created the third object C but with no parameter. In this case, it called default constructor. And there is a line like this, C equal to sum of A comma B actually calls the friend function and it performs the addition of the two real numbers A and B and at last it stores the result into C variable. Now I want to display all the complex numbers A, B and C. We use this line C out A and with the help of show function we can get the result of value of object A. This is C out B, show B will going to display the value of object B and third will display the object C. We can also have another addition for three complex numbers P, Q and R here created. We can again take values into P and Q by calling the constructor method explicitly here. P equal to complex 2.5 comma 3.9. It means this real part 2.5 and 3.9 is the imaginary part. 1.6 is real part and 2.5 is imaginary part. And again, if you call R equal to sum of P comma 5, P comma Q, it will perform the addition of two complex number P and Q, and result will be displayed with the help of these three C out statements. First will display P object, next will display Q, and third will display the object values of R object. You will see the result on the screen like this. In the object value A, B and C, P, Q and R. So this is the program for constructor overloading. Our main focus should be only on the different constructors written inside the class. Here the name of the constructor is same. The same method is used to perform different tasks. First method, constructor method, is responsible for assigning the default values to the parameters x and y. Next constructor takes only one value. It means that in this case real and imaginary parts are same. In third constructor method, it took two parameters where real part goes to x and imaginary part goes to y. So in different function call, it performed different tasks. That's why it is called as constructor gets overloaded. So this ends on a topic of constructor overloading. If you have any question, now you can ask me the question on constructor overloading. Any questions, students? You can click on hand raise button for asking the question. Hello, any questions? No doubts. Okay. Florin and Pooja, any doubts? Okay, there are no doubts by the participants. So this ends your topic, constructor overloading. Thank you for watching this video.